good ball club. They play a very tough schedule all through the year, so it really tests them for these tournament games.
Well, they've lost six games, mostly to Detroit City League teams, and Powers North Central comes from way up in the Upper Peninsula. They're up by Menominee and Escanaba. They've only lost three games. They won by a point last night, and they're excited. They got their fans here. They think they can win.
They've got a very nice 1-2 punch, and Rick Hansen, who's averaging 18 points per ball game, and Scott Johnson, who's averaging 16. So we'll see if they can keep up with this very fast and talented Charger ball club.
They had exciting semifinal games last night at Jennison Fieldhouse in East Lansing, and Fred Heumann has the highlights of how those teams got here tonight with their wins last night.
Lansing Christian put on a passing clinic in the first half. Dan Visser to Don Visser to Doug Harkema for two. That is followed by Don Visser taking a pass from his twin brother Dan for a deke and layup. Christian scored the first 8 points of the game. Harkema found Don Visser, who coaxed a shot in. 8-0 Christian. The Jets stormed back and took the lead 75-74 on a drive for two by Rick Hansen, who had 17 second half points, including his team's final eight. Christian had one last chance to win it, but a shot at the buzzer went around. And Powers North Central moves into the finals. For Christian, the despair that goes with defeat. The Jets will meet Detroit East Catholic in the finals. East Catholic going after its fifth state title in the last 6 years. The Chargers a 69-59 winner in the semifinals over Maple City Glen Lake, despite Ron Winowicki's 23 points. Antonio Shorter with 23 and 15 rebounds for East Catholic. The Chargers win 69-59. We'll be back with the starting lineups on the Michigan High School Basketball Network.
Okay, here we go. Back at Chrysler Arena, Class D, Detroit East Catholic 20-6 against Powers North Central 24-3. And now let's go to Howard King, the public address announcer here at the University of Michigan, for the introduction of the starting lineups for tonight's game.
Number four, Lewis Acuff. For North Central, a 6'2 senior. Number 32, Rick Hansen. East Catholic's other forward is 6'6 senior, number 44, Antonio Shorter. Other forward for North Central, 6'2 junior, number 30, Gerald Whitens. The centers for East Catholic, 6'4 senior, number 23, Roderick Owes. For North Central at center, 6 foot sophomore, number 50, Jeff Willa. The guards for East Catholic, 5'11 senior, number 10, Mike McCormick. For North Central, 5'11 senior, number 24, Scott Johnson. The guard for East Catholic, 6'3 senior, number 24, Darrell Clements. And the North Central guard, 6'1 junior, number 12, Rodney Wells. East Catholic is coached by Dave Soles. North Central is coached by Robert Whitens.
So we're just about set to go now. Tim Staudt with Jim Hornberger and Fred Heumann, all ready to bring you this Class D game. Dave Soles in his 12th year as the head coach at East Catholic. In Class B this morning, if you missed it, Oak Park won the state title, defeating Saginaw Buena Vista 63-54. And in Class A this afternoon, Flint Northwestern defeated Detroit Southwestern 64-43. Our officials for tonight's game in this Class D championship at Chrysler Arena in Ann Arbor, Bob Dement and Tom Watson. And we are just about set to go. This will be an interesting contrast. Jim, you have the inner city team from Detroit against the only representative from the Upper Peninsula. And I mean, they are a long way away from home. They're something like 150 miles from the bridge, from the Mackinac Bridge. They drove here, and they've been on a long trip, including the quarterfinals and semifinals last night. They're near Escanaba and Menominee, Powers North Central. This is the farthest they have ever gone in the state tournament, and the red-white fans of the Jets are here tonight. But East Catholic wins the tip and will underway. Jim and I have seen East Catholic for a number of years. They're going for 5 out of 6 in the state championship column, and their first shot is no good, and North Central's going to come out running. They rallied from a 13-point deficit last night to defeat Lansing Christian 75-74 in Jenison, so they have poise. And we'll see what kind of a ball club they have on the floor tonight. 24 is Scott Johnson. His point guard near here, number 12, is Rodney Wells. He's going to let it go. Some decent size inside here. They battle around for it underneath. And it's pulled out of here by Roderick Oves, number 23. Now the ball's out of bounds. That's our first turnover against East Catholic.
Colors is an up-tempo ball club, but tonight they're going to try to play a little bit more within themselves because East Catholic is a very adroit run-and-gun basketball game, and I can see right now that East Catholic usually plays a 2-3 zone, but for this game, they've opened in the man.
Shot way outside is off the mark by Scott Johnson. Ball is loose on the floor. You see the Jets working hard, and they take a 2-0 lead. Put up on him by Rick Hansen.
Hansen comes up with a lot of scraps around the basket. He has very quick hands, and he gets a lot of loose balls and puts them back up.
All right, so we have a 2-0 game now. Now we'll see if East Catholic, a team that can go in spurts, shot is up and in to tie it up by Darrell Clements. He's averaging 14 a game to lead his ball club.
Their leading scorer, they have very good balance on the East Catholic ball club this year. Clements was voted to the Associated Press All-State Class D ball club.
East Catholic only shot 42% last night in defeating Maple City Glen Lake 69-59. You saw the highlights in our pregame notes by Fred Heumann. Now they drive baseline. Shot is going to be no good in here by Darrell Clements, and it's pulled out of there by the Jets. I think North Central might be able to hang in there physically for a while. They've got three big kids up front by Class D standards. And
well, their big concern is trying to negate East Catholic on the glass because they do not have the size that East Catholic does with Antonio Shorter, who goes 6'7", and Oves, who goes 6'4".
There's our first foul of the game. It goes against Mike McCormick. That is his first, and that's the first team foul, of course. 2-2 is our score with 5:59 to go. And so to inbound the ball will be Gerald Whitens. He's the son of the head coach. Inside they go. Shot is no good up here by makes it a 4-2 ball game. So Powers North Central manages to get that one to go beautifully. Whitens is the man who got it. And for Gerald Whitens, that is his first 2 points. 4-2 now, the Upper Peninsula Club leading. And just like that, Darrell Clements comes back and ties it.
They've got to get a hand in the face of Clements because that's his comfort zone, and that's the weak spot against that 2-3 zone on the flank.
Central 24-3 coming in tonight. Here's the shot, kind of intimidated in there by East Catholic's Roderick Oves, and back down they come. Scott Johnson really didn't get a good shot off. Here's Mike McCormick. Darrell Clements, as Jim said, that's his zone. He missed it that time. McCormick puts it back up and in. Mike McCormick, and it's a 6-4 game now. Mike McCormick is a 5'11 senior. This is another young team that Dave Souls has, and he just kind of owns the Class D tournament the last
few
years.
Nice reverse pivot.
Beautiful shot block in here by Harry Pittman. Down the floor comes East Catholic. They're running. And the ball is batted out of bounds. It'll go back to East Catholic. 6-4 our score. East Catholic leading 4:46 to play in the first quarter. We have a big doubleheader for you tonight to end the 1984 basketball season. The Class C game's going to be spectacular, we think, so we hope you'll be with us for that one. Kalamazoo Christian trying to defend its title and win its 47th straight game. Oh. Little traveling's got to be the call. 2 turnovers on the East Catholic club, so North Central has a chance to come back down and tie it.
Token pressure put on by Detroit East Catholic. Very quick ball club. Opening with the man.
All right, inside. You can see he has trouble, and that shot's rejected. The foul is called. And that one will go against Roderick Oves. That is his first, second team foul. And it will put Douglas Willow on the line for Powers North Central.
Now, Willow was very fortunate because the East Catholic defender bailed him out. He was taking an off-balance turnaround jump shot. And he'll get two opportunities.
Willow is a 6'1½", 180-pound junior. And as you can see, he's got some kind of build on him. So Powers North Central has a number of key players who will be back next season. They only start two seniors on this team.
We only got two seniors on the whole squad. And they're their two top scorers, Hansen and Johnson.
6-4, East Catholic by two. So now we have a 6-5 game. Haven't had any nail biters so far today. Oak Park and Flint Northwestern have proven to be very sound clubs who led most of the way in their game. Turnaround shot is no good by East Catholic's Harry Pittman, and it's pulled down out of there by the Jets. This is Rodney Wells, the point guard, who will set it up. He has Scott Johnson with him in the backcourt. Johnson goes into the paint. The whistle blows, and a foul is called, and that one again is against East Catholic.
Good crossover dribble there by Johnson as he took the ball down the lane.
Darryl Clements has the foul. That's his first third-team foul. So far, no personals yet on Powers North Central.
I like the way, though, Powers is challenging East Catholic, taking the ball at them, and they're sticking their nose right in there.
There's a shot from way outside. Will not fall for Gerald White. He's put back up by Willow. That won't go, and Clements, excuse me, for East Catholic, Roderick Ose goes up and pulls it down. 6-5 now, East Catholic, 3:45 to play first quarter. East Catholic has its moments where it plays very well and then another time not so well. And on the other hand, that's true for North Central. Whiten says his team makes way too many turnovers. Here's our first foul against North Central in the ball game. Brandon Neely has checked into the game for East Catholic. Is that Wells that got the foul? Rodney,
yes.
Wells got that foul. So that is the first team foul on Powers North Central.
Pittman checking out for the Chargers.
Harry Pittman out. So a couple of substitutions now. Brandon Neely, 21, Anthony Bell, 54. And shooting is Lewis Acuff, who has his first point of the night, makes it a 7-5 game, East Catholic. We have 3:34 to go here in the first quarter tonight from Chrysler Arena in Ann Arbor. We had two crowds of more than 13,000 earlier today. Acuff 2-for-2, make it 8-5, East Catholic on top. Jets have had a little trouble scoring the last couple times down the floor, not getting the shot they want. Inside, there's the shot they want, and it's up there in beautifully by Rick Hansen. That's four for him. They get 8-7 now.
Nice float pass from Johnson to Hansen, and Hansen used the head fake extremely well. Nice strip there.
Beautiful job. Three turnovers on East Catholic. Down they come. Missed the puppy layup. Scott Johnson, and a travel is called against East Catholic, and North Central will get it back. Jim, the turnovers so far, 4 for East Catholic, none for North Central. And North Central's biggest weakness, according to its coach, is turnovers. And the Jets don't have one yet.
They're averaging 18 turnovers a ball game, and they can't have that. Again, a good head fake and putting it in. He got the defender to overcommit and use the glass very well.
Rick Hansen with 6 of his team's 9 points. And back out in front is the UP team, Power North Central. And another turnover on East Catholic, and that's 5 on the Chargers. Dave Sewells is up and yelling at his club. He is not happy with the way things are going at the moment.
Hansen uses his body very well inside for a player that's only 6'2", getting shots off over Antonio Shorter, who is 6'7", and Roderick Ose, who is 6'5".
There's a man down, no call. Shot from the baseline won't go, and it's ripped away by Roderick Ose, and down comes East Catholic. 21, Brandon Neely with the ball. We'll set it up outside. And Anthony Bell says, I'll fire and hit. Anthony Bell, number 54. And that makes it a 10-9 game, East Catholic, with 2:20 to play in the first quarter. Ball nearly stolen. And now a foul. Nice play by Scott Johnson to draw the foul. He maneuvered his body perfectly and drew the foul from Anthony Bell. Take a good look again, Jim, and this was well played. He stopped. I guess that's contact. 2:15 to play, first quarter, 10-9, Detroit East Catholic over Powers North Central. At the end of the 1984 high school season, they had more than 700 schools again this year take part, and we're going to be down to four winners by the end of tonight.
Once again, Hansen's,
and he's there
with the quick hands against those garbage points. He did it against Lansing last night, the entire ball game. He's very, very good at stripping the ball from you when you come down with a defensive rebound.
Rick Hansen has 8 of his team's 11. They dump it off to Darryl Clements, and he answers. Darryl Clements at 6 for him. Make it 12-11. East Catholic, a minute 43 to go in the first quarter.
Clements is a very nice stationary shooter.
Now they'll set it up outside. Scott Johnson looking around for some help. Down they go. Free throw line jumpers perfect by Rodney Wells. Nice extension on his shot. That makes it 13-12 North Central. Back and forth they go. East Catholic was the solid favorite coming in, but Powers North Central came to play. There's a foul, and that one will go against North Central's Gerald Whitens. I said a moment ago that he was the son of the coach. That's not correct. He's the cousin of the coach, Richard Whitens. And so Gerald Whitens, who has 2 points, has his first foul now. And you get a good look here at Darryl Clements, who's perhaps the best player on this team. He's an all-city player in Detroit. Very fine 6'3 senior guard. He'll play in college somewhere. He can tie the score with a free throw here. This is a two-shot situation. 7 points, 7 of the 13 for Darryl Clements. His average is 14 a game. Clements only had 10 points last night. He made 5 out of 19 shots last night against Maple City Glen Lake. So he fired at will, but he didn't have any salvos.
Yeah, he was a designated misser last night.
Yep. But he's back and he's rolling. He's got 8 points. 14-13 East Catholic. Now into the game will be number 42 for North Central, John Charles, a 6'5 junior. They got a little size on this club, Jim. John Charles in, Douglas Willow went out. It's a 14-13 East Catholic lead with a minute and 10 to go here in the first quarter. North Central trying to find some help inside here.
Nice crossover dribble.
Scott Johnson gets it to fall, his first two. The UP kids came to play tonight, 15-14. North Central over East Catholic, 51 seconds to play in the first quarter. Well played quarter.
Cardinal sent as a defender there. He gave up the baseline and Powers took advantage of it.
Shot outside, no good. Look at Clements. Battle for the board, left-handed. That's an air ball. And it comes out of there to Rick Hansen, who's had a big first quarter for his team. Hansen driving down all the way. He lays it up in the window. And they rip down the rebound. Roderick Ghost clears the ball away down here to Brandon Neely, who fires and scores.
He's a very good-looking sophomore.
16-15 East Catholic. We've had 6 lead changes so far here in the first quarter. Now whistle.
They call him for double dribble. He used the ball, got stuck on his thigh there.
First turnover on North Central comes with 13 seconds to go in the first quarter. So East Catholic has a chance to move its lead to 3 points here.
Rodney didn't keep his head up that time, and he didn't notice the double team coming.
Here's a shot from the top of the key. That's going to be way short. Let's see if he can get a 1 second, and they won't get the shot off. That is the end of the first quarter of our Class D State Championship game. It's Detroit East Catholic 16, Powers North Central 15. This is the Michigan High School Basketball Network. Tim Staudt, along with Jim Hornberger, back here at Chrysler Arena in Ann Arbor. Our official attendance tonight, 13,609. That's a sellout. So we've had 40,000 through here through 3 sessions today. The only game that a sellout was Class B, and they had over 13,000.
Hanson is a very good leaper. He got the tip there.
Shot from the baseline is pulled up and in by Gerald Whitens. 4 for him. And again, Powers North Central in the lead. And that's 7 lead changes now. Down the floor, shot from the baseline is in and out, will not go, off the hands of Anthony Bell. Now North Central comes down with a chance to take its biggest lead of the evening.
You have the feeling on offense, East Catholic can get the ball inside anytime they want to, but they're not showing the patience or the poise to do it right now.
All right, Rodney Wells dumps it back in the corner and out they go. They'll set it back up, Scott Johnson on the point.
Trying to isolate Hansen over there.
Turn around high feed. The problem was there wasn't high enough, and the guy didn't jump high enough. That's a second turnover down the floor. They're going to call traveling and nullify the basket. So that's already 6 turnovers on East Catholic. North Central has just 2, and North Central will get the ball back with a 1-point lead.
Hansen is only 6'2", but he plays very strong inside, and he's averaging 16 rebounds per ball game. By far and away the leading rebounder for Powers North Central.
7 minutes left in the second quarter. Ball momentarily loose. Now it is
hands quick.
Now it's stolen and a whistle, and now it's turned over. Back it goes.
And over and back.
Seven turnovers. 6:54 to go in a half. 17-16. As you look at some of the 13,609, they will inbound the ball right in front of us.
Powers guards are not keeping their head up. They're getting their eyes on the floor too much, and they're getting caught in those double teams. They're not hitting the open man.
Baseline jumper just misses, but a foul is called, and that one will go against Deep Catholic's Anthony Bell, and that'll be his second. That is also the fifth team foul. So they'll be in the 1-1 from now on and shoot two on this possession. Scott Johnson, who has 2 points tonight, will go to the line. Well, North Central has certainly accorded itself very well so far, Jim. No question about it. Scott Johnson, free throw is good. 3 points for him, 18-16. And we have a large contingent of large for a Class D school from the Upper Peninsula. And as Jim said, they came a long, long way. They got a long trip home tomorrow, but it'd be an awful lot shorter if they take that state championship trophy home with them. And they lead 19-16 at this point. Ball stripped away. That's another turnover on East Catholic. That's eight of them.
They can get the ball into that low post anytime they want to, but they didn't come up with a handle on it on that one.
19-16. You see the Jets operating outside. They don't have the speed and quickness East Catholic has, but they're tough kids, and they've played hard so far. Here's another foul. That one will go against East Catholic. And that's Lewis Acuff whistled down for his first. Dave Souls now is going to make a change. He takes Antonio Shorter out.
Now, Hansen is very quick and very active down there. You can see where he's got the defender on his hip, and he never really got in front of him to deny the ball to him, and as a result, he committed the foul.
All right, on the line now will be Rick Hansen, who has 8 points. It's his first free throw attempt. This could be the largest lead for North Central, but of course, he doesn't get it loose on the floor, and then it comes away to East Catholic momentarily. Back they come. Down the floor, pull up a footer, pour down and in. Nice shot by Brandon Neely, who has 4 points. 19-18 North Central by one here, all with the 6 minute mark now of the second quarter.
Again, we find to isolate Hansen.
Nice fake with the head pad. He's fouled, so he'll shoot two. And the foul goes against the 23, Roderick Ose, and that is his second foul.
That is not an easy pass there by Scott Johnson either. Very good timing between them. Two-man basketball. Two on two.
So that puts on the line now Rick Hansen. Boy, free throws will be very big tonight for Powers North Central. You can see
they're only shooting 57% as a team, and Hansen at least scores only a 48% free throw shooter.
Well, he's 0 for 2 up there right now. Coach Robert Whitens just shakes his head across the way. I tell you, when you go 24-3 and shoot that kind of free throw record, you're fortunate.
A glasser.
He'll take it. We haven't seen one of those since the war years. 20-18 now, but he'll take it as right. And he's played so well, too. He's got 9 points, 20-18, 5:44 to go. Shot from outside. That one ties the game. Brandon Neely has 6 points. He's given his team some help from the perimeter. 5:28 to play in the half. North Central and East Catholic all tied up at 20 apiece. What a record Detroit East Catholic has in this division of basketball in this state. 4 state titles in the last 5 years. Beautiful baseline drive by Gerald White. 6 for him. 22-20.
Again, East Catholic is giving up the baseline. They're calling Brandon Neely again for a palming violation.
These officials, unlike the ones earlier today, are calling everything very, very closely, especially on the violations. We had a lot of contact let go today in the earlier game. Shot from outside, doesn't go look good for a moment.
And Hansen.
It's recovered by Rick Hansen. Whitens was the man who shot it. Here's a shot up. That one will not go by Hansen, and it comes out of there to East Catholic. All right, they can tie it up again.
They got the numbers.
Clements. Neal, that was a bad shot. Pulled out of there by Richard Willard. Down they come. East Catholic has not kicked into gear yet at all, no question about it. Here's the free throw line jumper. That's off. Tipped up. No. Comes out. These Catholic. Pace of this game is moving. Down the floor they go. Anthony Bell drives, scores. Does it count? No, he traveled. 10 turnovers on East Catholic.
Powers has got to get back better on defense. They're not peeling back when they miss those shots.
Timeout on the floor, 4:27 to play first half. Powers, North Central 22, Detroit East Catholic 20 on the Michigan High School Basketball Network. Tim Staudt with Jim Hornberger and Fred Heumann back here at Chrysler Arena in Ann Arbor. There's Dave Soles in his 12th season as head coach at East Catholic. What a remarkable job this man has done with his school and this team. They do not have a large fan following, but they sure do have a large contingent of good basketball players. Here's the shot by Richard Willow, digging inside, and he manages to get it up and down. Is that Hanson?
Hanson again, another strong power move. I'm mildly surprised that they are doing such a good job of negating East Catholic strength on the backboard.
11 points for Rick Hanson. Turnaround jumpers tipped around. Won't go, and it comes out of there to North Central. 24-20. The Upper Peninsula team smelling the kill. Their confidence has to be gaining, Jim, every time they go down the floor and score. 3:53 to go here in the first half.
Stay going to a double stack.
Baseline jumper in on, no good. It comes back loose on the floor. Turn around Hanson. Yes, he gets all garbage.
He gets all garbage underneath.
Rick Hanson with 13 points.
If it's on the floor, it's his ball.
26-20, biggest lead for North Central. Clements is way off of that shot. Bell put it back up, but he was fouled.
Fouled by Hanson.
So Rick Hanson has his first, that is only the third team foul against Powers North Central.
He is so active underneath, constantly moving. And as a result, he comes up with a lot of those loose balls.
Well, the Upper Peninsula has not had a state champion here in a while, and they would love to get one here today.
They get it. Go.
Loose on the floor. Down they come, and a whistle and a foul is called. And that one will go against Brandon Neely, and that is his first.
Antonio Shorter went into a mental free fall there. He never went after the basketball.
Well, it was a weird pass.
Well, you got to get it.
You see why Dave Sewell's hair is gray. He's had a little trouble getting these guys to be consistent through much of the year, but they've sure played well in the tournament for him. But his team is struggling right now. North Central 26-20 with 3:24 to go. Here's Rodney Wells.
Oh, man, do these guys shoot free throws bad.
Yeah, they do, but they're still up by six. Anthony Bell, that was a nice move and poor defense, but Anthony Bell gets it to fall. That's four for him, 26-22. They have missed, Jim. They've made four out of 8 free throws now tonight. 26-22. Now North Central.
Double team. He picks up his dribble. He's in trouble. Again, into Hanson.
Hanson puts it up. Get up, get up. Floor. It's no good. Here's on the floor. More garbage. One goes. Battle underneath. Out of here to Clement. He goes ahead to Anthony Bell.
Got
the numbers inside. Yes, nice play. They got back in a hurry. Antonio Shorter has his first two, and it's 26-24.
Beautiful drop pass there for the easy basket. He did such a nice job of throwing the ball as the man was getting open, not after he was open.
Scott Jensen scores. Nice play. Four for him. Six for him.
He's a player.
28-24 for Scott Johnson. On that bucket, that gives him six, as I said. 2:22 to go. Darryl Clements has been kind of silent here, Jim, the last couple of minutes.
They're not getting back, Catholic, on defense right now.
Dumps it off. Nice play. And foul is called. I think right now, Staudt Central's just out hustling East Catholic.
That's exactly right. East Catholic could use a timeout. They're very lackadaisical right now.
Well, take a look again. Anthony Bell.
Beautiful pass.
Jim, that's his third personal foul already. So he's in trouble, and he sits down.
And he's their second leading scorer.
Anthony Bell, one of the top players on this East Catholic team. 6 foot sophomore. So on the line is Rodney Wells. Boy, if this comes down to free throw shooting, it might be a little tough because, as Jim said, this is not a good free throw team. And yet, that makes it 29-24 now. 2:13 to go. Maybe we'll have our first upset of the day tonight.
Yep. You're right. So far in this ball game, Powers is simply out hustling them for the basketball.
They're just scrapping for it hard, and they didn't come all this way to lose. Wells has 4 points now. 30-24 equals the biggest lead for the Jets tonight.
And I don't think the Chargers expected this tough a ball game.
Nope. Now a whistle and a foul is called against North Central. And that one goes against Rodney Wells. And that'll be his second. You have to wonder what the Lansing Christian players are thinking tonight. They blew a 13-point lead against this club and lost by one last night. We have timeout on the floor with 2:03 to go. Powers North Central 30, Detroit East Catholic 24. And so right now, I think North Central's coach wanted to just get it, his act together here for these last 2 minutes of this first half. 2:03 to go. Powers North Central leading 30 to 24 over Detroit East Catholic. Wonder what North Central wanted with that timeout, Jim.
Well, I think it was a good call there because they want to try to maintain this lead right now, maybe even hold on to the ball, protect it real well, see if they can keep the lead going into the locker room here at half. There's a very poor inbounds play.
Out of bounds.
The ball out of bounds.
13-3 in turnovers.
Another
now.
Lackadaisical move there by the Chargers.
13-3 in turnovers.
Just hold the ball, protect it a little bit, and I think this will be a very big morale booster for Powers.
Shot, that's going to be way short, but it's scrapped underneath, put up and in. Rick Hansen gets the garbage, as Jim says. He has
made
15 points of his team's 32. Their biggest lead, 32-24. They've had a big quarter here. And the ball is turned over again, 14 turnovers. And North Central now has the ball. They have outscored Detroit East Catholic in this quarter, 17-8. And the Chargers look a little confused right now.
The Chargers need a leader right now to pump them up and get them going.
They're
right now, they got their dobber down, and there's a very poor pass.
Well, that's their fourth turnover. As I told you, North Central worries about them. They've only had four. It's going to be firing time here momentarily with a minute 14 to go, and Darryl Clements is the man to do it. He hits it. He is fouled, and I believe the basket will count. Darryl Clements has his 10th.
An unusual player in as much as most left-handers like to shoot from the left side, but he prefers to shoot from the right side of the floor.
Gerald Whitens has the foul, his second. So that makes it 32-26 now.
Got a very nice looking jump shot, good form, nice technique, very good release.
So here's Darryl Clements on the line with 10 points. East Catholic has made all four of its free throw attempts, but it has struggled tonight. Now North Central with a minute 9 to go. Do they want to run the clock here a little bit with that 6-point lead, or will they look inside? No call that they're going to do anything but just keep playing here. We're down to a minute to go in the first half.
Try to isolate Hansen again down low.
Shot from outside is poured up and in by Gerald Whitens. 8 points for him, and it's 34-26. Again, an 8-point lead, largest of the night for Powers North Central. East Catholic is in trouble. Clements drives from outside with a shot, no good. They put it back up, and that won't go. And it comes out of there to North Central again. Well, I'll tell you, this Rick Hansen has played his heart out so far tonight.
You wonder how a player 6'2 can average 16 rebounds a game.
Oh, they had a guy wide open on a 2-on-1 break, and it went right through the hands of Gerald Whitens, and that's the fifth turnover.
Gerald took his eye off the ball all the way. He was smelling an easy two.
Yeah, he knew he had to either with him or with his teammate down there, and it just went through there. So with 28 seconds to go, East Catholic will come down and bomb away here. 34-26. Inside they go, turnaround shot. That one is squared up and put down by Antonio Shorter. Four for him. 16 seconds to go, 34-28.
Haven't gotten the ball into Shorter the entire ball game, and he's 6'7", and nobody else is over about 6'2".
In they go. There's a whistle and a foul call, and that one will go against number 23 for East Catholic. As you see, Roderick goes. That is his third personal foul with 7 seconds to play.
Got to utilize Shorter a lot better in the second half than they did in the first half. He had a great ball game last night. He had 23 points and 15 rebounds in their win.
Well, Jim, when you realize that this school has absolutely no tournament tradition, that this is the farthest they've ever gone by a mile, the school was built in 1970, and they've kind of come out of nowhere with a big team. And that makes it 35-28 now.
And they only have two seniors on the entire squad. They are Johnson and Hansen, their two best ball players.
Break up the Jets. Boy, that's a Johnson's hit all four of his free throws. 7 seconds to go, 36-28. This is going to be a happy Jets team going off. Here's
the
shot.
Could have gotten much closer.
But that was his best bet, probably. And that's the end of the first half. And what a great first half it was for Powers North Central from the Upper Peninsula, taking control with a big second quarter. our halftime score here at Chrysler Arena. The Class D State Championship is Powers North Central 36 to Troy East Catholic 28 on the Michigan High School Basketball Network. Back here at Chrysler Arena, I'm Tim Staudt with Jim Hornberger and Fred Heumann. How did these teams arrive to this Class D state championship game tonight? Well, for Powers North Central, it was a pretty easy go, as you see, in the districts. Rapid River, Trinary, and Bark River. Those three teams all went down to an easy defeat. Watersmeet and unbeaten Dollar Bay were losers in the regionals. A big upset win over Dollar Bay. Big Beta Knock fell in the quarters. Lansing Christian by a point on a great comeback last night after being 13 down on the semis. That brings them here. East Catholic beat a very good Allen Park team in the regionals, bombed Hamtramck Immaculate Conception and Detroit Bethesda. In the regionals, it was this kind of goal. Royal Oak, St. Mary, and Cardinal Mooney. Not too tough right there. East Catholic doing very well. They beat Kindy North here on a very good team in the quarters. Maple City, Glen Lake last night, no problem. Here's the stats, Jim. 44-41%. That's pretty close in field goals. Free throws are pretty close, although the Jets have had twice as many they've made. Rebounds are close. But look at the turnovers, 15-7, and that has allowed Powers North Central to score a little more and certainly get some more shots. So nobody's really shooting that well, but the difference really has been in the turnovers.
And in the rebounding, because East Catholic came into this ball game and they felt that they were going to control the glass, and in the first half they were actually out-rebounded.
All right, inside, here's our turnover to start things in the second half for North Central. Now East Catholic, let's see what they can do.
They've got to get the ball to Antonio Shorter more, because he only took three shots in the first half. He made two and only came up with two rebounds.
Darryl Clement nearly got a foul there. Clement's had 10 points at the half, 36-28. They have a full house, and this is our first possible upset today.
That was Rick Hansen's eighth rebound in the ball game, and he's had five of those on the offensive end.
We'll talk with Bill Frieder, Michigan's NIT semifinal coach here after tonight's first game between the doubleheader. There's another foul inside against East Catholic.
Antonio Shorter, he's not in proper defensive denial position.
That's his first team foul.
Hansen is very adept at getting you on his hip, and then he uses a good head fake, body fakes to get you to overcommit.
Inside ball is stripped away momentarily, and a whistle and another foul is called. So they immediately start piling up. This time Lewis Acuff gets his second team foul.
East Catholic is very laid back right now. They need somebody to set a spark for them, get them going.
Well, maybe it'll be Sport Goofy. Who knows?
Yeah. They're showing no enthusiasm right now at all.
All right, on the line, you see, for Powers North Central, Douglas Willa, who is 1-for-2 from the line tonight. He has 1 point. 6'2", junior center.
Very flat shot there.
30
trajectory.
Nobody has scored yet in the second half. We have played 44 seconds.
Yeah,
get it up. All right, there's the biggest lead of the night by Powers North Central, 37-28. Everybody said what a great upset it was in 1977 when Maple City Glen Lake beat East Catholic in the finals, and it was a big upset. Whether this would be bigger, who knows, but it'd be a big one. Inside they go to Shorter, as Jim said they had to do. Six for him, 37-30. And I think that
shot's... no problem. He's 6'7", getting the ball.
The shot's been there, too.
It's been there all night. They haven't been patient offensively.
The ball just hadn't been there. Whistle, there's another foul. That one's too close. Darryl Clements, is it Clements that got it, 24? We'll wait and see. We've got a lot of hand motions there.
You know, Antonio Shorter is 6'7", and the man guarding him is only 6'2". Now, if you can't post up a man that's 5 inches shorter than yourself, you have no business being out there. And he's a good athlete.
Clements with two fouls, 37-30 inside. There's another foul called. No, they're going to call this
offensive
one on Powers North Central.
On Hansen for pushing off.
So Rick Hansen has two fouls now. North Central has another turnover out of that call. 37-30. Powers North Central has led by as many as nine at 37-28. It's biggest lead. Okay, now East Catholic with a chance to cut it to five. There's the man Shorter. He's open to three. He mistimed his shot. Got it blocked. Out of bounds. It will, I believe, go back to East Catholic. You're right, Jim. They should just look for this guy the rest of the night.
Well, he'll loosen up the defense, too.
37-30. There he is. That's a poor shot.
They don't have to take those kinds of shots if they'll be patient.
Down the floor they go. They have, boy, that was a foul, no call.
Got a breakaway here at the other end. Clevis won't throw him the ball, though.
Very well.
Yeah, thank you.
Louis Acuff makes it four for him, 37-32. That was a missed call at the other end of the floor, though. And he nearly got hurt down here hitting the standard of the basket. That was a steam. There's got to be a foul on East Catholic. Boy, some of the fouls they pick up are unreal.
There was no defensive communication there at all. His teammates should have told him the pick was being set up outside because he had no idea and steamrolled the man setting the pick, and he had ample time to change his direction.
There's some brain trust of college basketball. John Orr and Bill Creter, who used to be coaching together at Michigan. John's been here all day long. We had a nice visit with him after the Class A game. He kept calling me Jeff because his mind was on Jeff Grayer, a player Northwestern. I don't blame him the way Jeff Grayer played either. My mind was on Jeff Grayer. Inside they go. Shot is put up too hard. They battle around for the board, and that one comes out to Shorter, who's playing with a little more intensity now. 37-32. They can cut it to three with a bucket right here.
Got to take the time, send it up to the low post. And again, an off-balance shot by Shorter. He didn't have to take that. Good follow-up by Roderick Oles.
So Roderick Oles gets that one to fall. Down the floor they come, 37-34, a 9-point lead. They've had six straight points for East Catholic now. Turnaround square-up shot won't fall again. Once again, it comes out of there to East Catholic. This is Brandon Lee in the play. Ooh, Clements really took a hard ball. He made the basket, and he goes down very hard, and I hope he is not hurt too badly. He was holding his leg. Boy, he made a nice move, too. Clements has 12 points, and that cuts it to 37-36. That is eight straight points for East Catholic.
Powers is not peeling back on defense, and East Catholic is a very quick team. You've got to get back. You can't give them the numbers. Now they're coming up with full court pressure. This is a good move by David Soles because it gets his team running. They've been very lethargic.
All right, let's see how North Central can handle the defensive pressure. They've had a remarkable game so far, but they're in trouble now of losing their lead. They've given up eight straight points. 37-36 is the score. 5:04 to go. That's a bad pass. Stolen away again. Down the floor they come, and there's a foul.
Hanson tripped and fell.
And that's a bad foul for Hanson because that's his third. And well, I tell you, we're going to have injuries here before it's over. We're going to get a timeout here. Robert White just wants a timeout from his team with 4:59 to go, third quarter. Powers North Central 37, Detroit East Catholic 36 on the Michigan High School Basketball Network. East Catholic has a chance to take the lead with a bucket here. They're going to have to surround Antonio Schroeder. He's got way outside, is poured up and in by Darryl Clements, and now it is, that makes Jim 10 straight points for East Catholic, and from being nine down, they're now one up. That's the kind of team they have been all year. They're very streaky, and that's 14 points for Darryl Clements so far. 4:37 to go. North Central hoping now to get something going. They've been stagnant on offense.
They're having a difficult time now getting the ball into Hanson. They're playing the passing lanes much better on defense.
Man-to-man has been bothering this team here down the floor. They dump it off. That's batted away. Out of bounds, and it's East Catholic. Now, as I told you, this is a team bothered by turnovers, and they're starting to pick them up. Nine for North Central now, and yet 14 for East Catholic. 4:17 to go. East Catholic with a chance to take its lead even higher. And score its 12th straight point inside. Shot good. 12 straight points. Roderick Oles has four. 40-37.
They finally got Oles and Shorter involved in the offense, and that's why they've ran off this streak of unanswered points.
12 points in a row. Jump shot, turn around, won't go. Tip, no, and it comes out of there to East Catholic. So Roderick goes down the floor they come. Clement stops, pops, won't go, whistle inside.
Foul on Antonio Shorter pushing off.
He knew it, and that's his second foul. Well, that'll help stop the bleeding perhaps a little bit. Boy, it's amazing how these games go in streaks back and forth.
Antonio Shorter, second personal.
Well, this could be a saving grace for the Powers North Central. They're in the 1-1 already.
40-37, 3:45 to play here in the third quarter. On the line is Rodney Wells. Now he is two out of three for tonight at the free throw line. And boy, they have got to make these free throws here down the stretch to hang in there and perhaps pull off an upset.
Good rotation on the ball there by Wells. He's shooting 63% from the line, which is the second best on the team. They have a little trouble at the stripe, the Jets. They're only shooting 57% this year.
All right, Wells 3 out of 4. Wells is now 4 out of 5. So all that stopped the streak at 12, and it's now 40-39, East Catholic by a point. This one's been very close most of the night, and we've had a number of lead changes. Shot poured up and in beautifully by Darryl Clements, who's on the mark a little now.
They've got to shade that zone more toward Clements and overplay him a little bit. They're not doing that, and they're giving him that stationary 15, 17-foot jumper.
16 points for Clements. East Catholic again by 3, 3:22 to go. Shot from outside, up and good. Nice shot by Gerald Whiten. That's 10 for him, 42-41, East Catholic by 1. Clements feels it, and he's got it, 18 for Clements.
Hey, this is great if you're Detroit East Catholic, but if you're Powers North Central, you've got to get a hand in his face pretty soon.
Well, that was a line drive shot, not a lot of arch on that one. Three-point game, they try the lob, that's a bad pass.
They're just taking it down every time and taking it right to the right corner right now.
Inside they go, Shorter puts it up, no. Look at them battle for it, no. And it comes out to North Central. They're going to run
outlet
here.
Outlet pass.
Scott Johnson wheels, and he's fouled for the one. They fly through the air with the greatest of ease, and the foul is on Louis Acuff. That's his third, and it, again, it will put Scott Johnson on the line, who has made all four free throws. Now, Jim, this looked like a flying trapeze here. We got a good shot from our end camera. Acuff gets the reach in, spins. Now watch the flying theatrics. Everybody goes up, and there's no ball anywhere. Very nice. It would have been a good high jump if there would have been a bar there for Roderick Ose. He got up pretty high. Free throw is good by Scott Johnson. Boy, these are crucial. 9 for him, 5 for 5 from the line, 44-42, Detroit East Catholic.
Scott on his free throw is not following through real well. He's not getting the ball up on the trajectory. That time he did. He didn't have that same flat shot that he had on the previous one.
6 for 6, 44-43, East Catholic. 2.5 minutes to play in the third quarter. Shot from way outside, totally ill-advised. And that comes back to North Central.
They're not patient offensively, the Chargers. If they were patient offensively, every time down the floor, they'd get a very good high percentage shot. Nice head fake.
That was, oh, and they're going to get a gimme underneath. Rick Hansen there with the garbage to clean it up.
Who else would it come to but Hansen?
That's 17 points for him. That's his first two in the second half. And North Central leads 45-44. Ose puts it back up and in. Roderick Ose, 6 for him. And East Catholic has the lead by 1. Well, we've got our first real close game now, the first one that's really in doubt here tonight. And we should have a great game in Class C to end the night. Baseline jumper was another ill-advised shot. Comes loose on the floor, and it's stolen back away by North Central. Down, up, no.
Again, Hansen's got the inside position, but he couldn't come up with the errant ball.
Because he didn't have the height. It's some things you don't have, and height he just couldn't get. And it's stolen away again. 16 turnovers on East Catholic.
Clements does not shoot off the dribble well at all. He's an outstanding stationary shooter, but he has trouble off the dribble.
Johnson wheels, puts it up and in. Scott Johnson. That is 12 for him. And again, North Central takes the lead, 47-46.
Fingertip roll by Johnson.
Boy, at some point, somebody's going to have to play some defense down at the other end of the floor for East Catholic. Clements wheeling, dealing, off balance, won't go. Bad shot selection again for East Catholic. You know what worked for them was when they were going to Antonio Shorter inside. As Jim said, he could have a one-footer every time down the floor if they just wait to get it to him.
And Roderick Ose also.
They're the only two that don't handle it in the offense. Johnson, yeah. Rodney Wells. 8 points for him, 49-46. The Powers North Central, which had an eight-point lead, lost it. An eight-point lead at the half, lost it. Now back up by 3. There's Shorter. Look at the shot he gets. Turn around, squares up. 8 for him, 49-48.
You know, you can run a real nice, simple Simon offense, I like to call it. You know, get the ball to the shooters and let them shoot.
Stolen away nicely. Uh-oh, this could be...
I don't think he's going to give it up either.
And he misses the shot with 10 seconds to go. All right, now with 7 seconds to go, this one's going to be a frantic finish. That's got to be a foul with 2 seconds to go. You know, Jim, when you see the mistakes of a team like East Catholic, makes you wonder sometimes how they've won 4 state titles in 5 years, and yet they've done it.
Oh.
John Charles checks back in. That was on, we'll check who the foul is on. Take a look again. That's the 4th personal foul, and I didn't get who it was.
Acuff.
So Louis Acuff has 4. He's the first man to have 4. 17-7 in personal fouls tonight. 17 for East Catholic and 7 for Howard Nelson. All right, Scott Johnson, 6-for-6 from the line. His team leads by 1.
Detroit East Catholic is an excellent team. They finished in 3rd place in the Operation Friendship games in the city of Detroit this year, and they play a very difficult schedule.
50-48, 2 seconds. This will be good. Let her go. There she goes, and that'll be the end of the 3rd quarter. In our Class D State Championship game from Chrysler Arena, our score, Detroit East Catholic trailing Powers North Central 50-48. This is the Michigan High School Basketball Network. Tim Staudt with Jim Hornberger and Fred Heumann back here at Chrysler Arena in Ann Arbor, where we have had a big day of the Michigan High School basketball tournament. We're looking perhaps at our first upset, if that score will hold. Powers North Central was outscored 20-14 in the 3rd quarter, but it had a 9-point lead at 37-28, gave up 12 straight points, and then rallied, and they've jockeyed back and forth. So we have 8 minutes remaining in regulation. Kalamazoo Christian and Hamilton will go in perhaps the best matchup of the day in Class C to follow this one. And we'll talk basketball between games with a number of guests, so we hope you'll stay right with us through 11 o'clock tonight. We'll send you to hoop heaven before this one is all over. Jump to North Central. John Charles controls it and sets it up, and now we have a whistle, and I guess they call double dribble.
No, the official, the jumper, caught the ball, and I was wondering if they were going to catch that. It took him 2 or 3 seconds to get it, but he did catch it. Hansen caught the ball.
Whatever. 7:55 to play, 50-48. Here's North Central.
But the Jets' 1-2 punch of Hansen and Johnson once again are having an outstanding game.
Shorter. Well, he went a little quick getting it off. The shot was there, but he spun in midair.
He doesn't square up like he should with a good head fake and maybe take it in strong on a good power move. He's shooting the shot as he's spinning.
50-48, and it's dribbled off the foot of Rodney Wells. Out of bounds, and it back to East Catholic.
Now watch the jumper, Hansen here. Once you tip it, you can't catch it again. And the official, hey, it's been a while, then he finally got it.
He said, hey, if it's going to come to me, I'm going to do some of it. Antonio Shorter, 10 for him, 50-50. He said, what am I supposed to do with it? It came right to me. All right, now they come into the forecourt with it. Rodney Wells, and he throws it away. Well, that's now 13 turnovers. They're slowly but surely starting to catch up with East Catholic in the turnover department.
Well, they've averaged 18 a game this year. And
well, they're close. 7:04 to play in regulation time. Clements to give his team the lead. And someone's on the back.
And a call it on Hansen.
He doesn't like it either. And that's 4 fouls on Rick Hansen. So he's going to have to be careful now. Robert Whitens is an interesting coach to watch from the standpoint that he really doesn't move, doesn't change too many players, doesn't get up off the bench much. That's Dave Sewells of East Catholic. But Robert Whitens just kind of sits and watches the game. If you gave him a box of popcorn, that'd be more movement than what he makes sitting on the bench. But what a job he's done, 24-3. 6:59 to play here, 4th quarter. That's what I call bunched in tight on the out-of-bounds play. And as often happens, we have another foul as the play was moved in rather easily. And Gerald Whitens has his 3rd foul.
Excellent inbounds play there by the Chargers. Whitens got rubbed off on the screen and had to commit the foul.
50-50 is our score with 6:58 to go. Interesting shot from behind the coach, the bench of the coach of Powers North Central, Robert Whitens, on the right of your screen there. There's the free throw attempt. That one is just not going to fall here for Anthony Bell. That was his first trip to the line. He has 4 points tonight. Bell rings it. And that's 5 for him. 51-50 East Catholic. 6:56 to play in the fourth quarter. Class D state championship. East Catholic, the favorite, struggling all night long. Powers North Central has played very well. Drive in, beautiful play. Scott Johnson, and he now has 15 points. You would think he doesn't have the speed to get in there without being stopped, but he had it.
He's very good at spotting that crease down the middle.
There's Antonio Shorter, yes. I'll tell you, when he gets the ball in squares, he's tough. 12 points, 53-52 East Catholic. 6:25 to go.
Again, no defensive verbal communication. You've got to help your teammate out to let him know that they're setting up that screen, and the Chargers have not done that the entire ballgame.
That one was against Brandon Neely, his second.
And David Soles, the coach for East Catholic right now, is scolding Bell because he did not call it out and tell his teammate, hey, they're setting a pick, and you've got to call that out. He said, it's your fault.
So the official.
So but Anthony Bell has to have some verbal communication there to let his teammate know they're setting up those three-quarter picks.
53-52, 6:24 to go. Free throw is a crier that comes out of there, no good. From Rodney Wells, so back down the floor they go. No rhyme or reason for that shot, but it comes loose on the floor, and it'll be saved out of bounds to, well, they figured out that's an East Catholic. No. Brandon Neely tends to get a little impatient, Jim, running their offense. He gives you that quick look inside. If there's no green, it's going up.
Here's Antonio Shorter. This guy could score for a state record if they'd be patient and get the ball into him in that low box position, but they haven't done it, and that's why they're in a real tough ball game.
Now it's a 3-0.
And again, you know, pretty soon East Catholic is going to get the hang of this.
I'll tell you who's paying a price is the North Central kid who's been taking the brunt of this attack.
Again, they do not call out the screen, and 21 runs him right over.
Rick Hansen says, well, you guys communicate, I'm dying on this play.
Very good camera work there to show how Brandon Neely got put out to dry.
You're going to use that videotape for his insurance agent. Because he's got to get a couple of dents repaired in him from what the problems he'd had going down. Hansen made it to cut it to 55-53. Missed that one. 55-53. For some reason, the D games are always the most entertaining. 5:47 to play. East Catholic with a two-point lead. Brandon Neely says, I'm hot. And he's not. And it comes back to Clements. And he's not. And it's loose on the floor. And they got a man wide open. Scott Johnson. Lays it up and in. Tie game. 17 points for Johnson, 5:27 to go. 55 all.
Oh, man, Brandon's got to be taking those shots.
So now Powers North Central will try to get into a flow here with 5:12 to play. Tie game at 55. They've played hard. Both teams have been a lot of mistakes. Turnaround shot. No, it's an air ball. Comes out to Brandon Neely. Let's see what he does with it this time. And he's going to call timeout. 4:59 to play in the fourth quarter. Powers North Central 55, Detroit East Catholic 55 on the Michigan High School Basketball Network. Tim Staudt along with Jim Hornberger and Fred Heumann and from Chrysler Arena in Ann Arbor. It is that close with 4:59 to go. Powers North Central gathers around Coach Robert Whiten, hoping to take a championship trophy back up to the Upper Peninsula with a victory here tonight. Jim?
Brandon Neely is coming over to take out the basketball for the Chargers. 4:59 to go. Let's see if they'll be a little bit more patient and show some good ball movement on offense. They haven't done it very much tonight. There they go inside.
Oh, and he missed the dog inside. Put back up. That one doesn't go in. Those were two shots that should have gone in. Back up, and that one finally does fall. Roderick Ohs, eight for him.
It is 17th rebound in the basketball game.
50s, boy, that's a ton of bounds in a high school game. And he still has 4:32 to go. 57-55, bad pass. Shorter pulls it away.
Good anticipation there by Shorter.
Down they go.
Charge. Good call by the official, Brandon Neely. is playing out of control the entire second half.
Neely now has his fourth personal foul as Dave Soles looks on. Neely goes flying in, and nice job by Scott Johnson to take the charge. Boy, has there been some contact in this game. 57-55, East Catholic, 4:24 to play in regulation. Here's Scott Johnson, tough kid.
He's had a couple of flat free throws. If he can get the arch up, again, flat, and he didn't get the roll.
However,
lane violation.
He got a break from the official on the lane violation. So he'll try again with 4:24 to go. We have a sellout crowd in here tonight, and I mean to tell you, they are packed in here. They're waiting for the Class C title game, too, and that promises to be perhaps like this one. Well, Johnson is still a little flat, but got it to go, and he's done a good job there. All right, now here's the lane violation.
Well, it's on Brandon Neely, it looks like. Number 21 was in the lane before the ball left the shooter's hand.
Yeah, but I don't know if he was, though. They look like everyone looks like the same one. Johnson hits the second one. You can see what a mistake that was, too. He has now made 9 out of 10 free throws. 19 for Johnson. Where would they be without him? Game tied. Shorter. Had trouble controlling it. East Catholic working inside. Boy, there's nobody to pass to. Then Shorter gets it back and scores. You're right. Boy, when he squares up, is he tough. He has 16 points, 12 in the second half. 59-57, 3:59 to play in regulation. North Central's played hard. That shot is blocked and a foul's called. Darrell Clements applauds the call after he didn't like it. That's three on him. So again, it comes down to free throw shooting, and Gerald Whitens will be on the line. What's he shooting? He hadn't been there tonight.
He's the leading free throw shooter this year. He's 72% from the charity stripe.
Well, they need him. As you see Dave Soles, he's got strings hanging out the back of his pants, his clipboard, his shirt sleeves are rolled up. He's kind of sweated this one out tonight. Whitens has all his points from the field. Now he has a free throw in there.
Played a nice, steady ball game.
11 for Gerald Whitens. This can tie it, and it does. 59 all, 3:54 to go. This is going to be a great finish here to this one. Detroit East Catholic going for state title number 5 in the last 6 years. Number 10 is Mike McCormick, and it's stolen away. Back down they come. Now the North Central Jets want to get a good shot here with 3:39 to play in the basketball game, and the score tied. And oh, he stopped his dribble. He's in trouble.
Pick up your dribble along the sideline. They got him hemmed in, and it resulted in the jump ball.
So that's a break for East Catholic. 3.5 minutes to play. We are tied at 59.
Big height differential, too, and Clements easily wins the tap.
Down the floor they come. Well, they didn't get the shot, excuse me, on that possession. Now Mike McCormick outside for East Catholic, looking for someone to set up the offense with. Inside Shorter, there he is. And that one doesn't fall, and it'll come out to North Central. Another fine rebound by Rick Hansen. Boy, what a game that kid has played tonight. And he has 4 personal fouls. 59 all. Down the floor, Rodney Wells. No, not the shot that takes Shorter on the board. Outlets it. Boy, these kids are tired on both sides tonight. 2:57 with down clock moving. Clements, for some reason, fires from outside.
That's Hansen's 12th rebound tonight. He's been very active at both ends of the floor.
Down the floor goes Scott Johnson, looking for the move inside. No one's going to stop him, and a foul is called. That'll send Johnson to the line. He's 9 for 10 there tonight.
Excellent crossover dribble by Johnson as he took the ball down the lane. He spots that crease and goes for the iron.
Roderick Goves has his 4th foul. Now we have 3 East Catholic players with 4 fouls. You can see they stepped in on him there. Good call, and Roderick Goves is in there and just blasts away. So, 59 all. Here is Scott Johnson. Yes, 10 out of 11. And he gives his team the lead. He has 20 points tonight. 60-59, 2:41 to go. North Central trying to win the Class D state title. A team that has absolutely no tradition in this tournament. They've gone all the way so far.
Clements climbed the ladder to get that very important carom.
Now down the floor comes Brandon Neely. 60-59, his team down by one. They're looking for Shorter or Clements, and there's Clements. Back over here, shot. That's going to be way off the mark. No good. Who gets the board? And it comes out of bounds back to East Catholic. Anthony Bell felled it, put it up. That was off to the right.
They've got a nice double post down low with Roderick Ows and Antonio Shorter. If they're patient, they can get the ball into them.
Here's Antonio Shorter, and he pumps it in. So Shorter makes it 61-60, East Catholic, 2:15 to go. He has 18 points, and he has saved his team in the second half with 14 of them. In the backcourt, and well, that time they don't call it. Contact was a little too incidental. 2 minutes to play. Johnson drives, no. That was maybe an ill-advised shot. And with a one-point lead and 1:54 to go, ball is tipped out of bounds. It'll go back to Detroit East Catholic. 1:52 to play. Anthony Bell.
Let's see if East Catholic now will go into a high offense to try to draw the Jets away from the basket.
Bell looking for help, and they throw it away. But it is saved, and then out of bounds, back to North Central with a minute 38 to go. Well, North Central was in a game exactly like this last night with Lansing Christian and scored in the final seconds to win.
Very poor judgment there, because there was no reason to take the ball into traffic like that. Take it down low. If nothing is there, take it back out and start over.
61-60, and there, that's got to be another foul. That one is on Brandon Neely, who did not hear. That is at least, that's his fifth.
Brandon, I guess he's Catholic. They don't talk to each other.
So Brandon Neely goes, he hit about three or four of those fouls. That's six on Brandon Neely, 6 points for Brandon Neely, and he's gone. And Mike McQuarrie, he's only a sophomore. And that will put on the line Rick Hansen, who is 2 for 5 tonight at the free throw line. So he needs these with a minute 28 to go. Boy, I talk about your big 1-1. What a job he has done tonight, but he can't get it to go. He's 2 for 6.
48% shooter from the free throw line.
Well, they'd like to have him hit that tonight. He's shooting 33%. 1:18 to go, a one-point game. We're down to gut check time for both of these clubs now, and East Catholic maybe going to let a little of the air out of it here. Although that's not their game, they dump it off. It is up, it's good. Nice play that time. Roderick goes, 10 points. Now it's a three-point game with a minute to play. Down the floor they come. They dump it off inside. Hansen, it doesn't go. And it comes out to East Catholic, and we have a jump ball. And they're fortunate to get a jump and not a foul.
Off balance shot there by Hansen. Plenty of time to go in the ball game. 54 seconds, and that was a very ill-advised shot.
63-60, East Catholic.
Now, East Catholic should get the jump. They've got the height advantage, and they're going to call timeout.
Timeout, 54 seconds to play. Detroit East Catholic, 63, Powers North Central, 60 on the Michigan High School Basketball Network. You take a look at the North Central bench down below as Coach Robert Whitens will discuss strategy here in the final moments. Well, it's been a game of mistakes so far. Especially in the second half, it was 37-28 at one time in the third quarter in favor of North Central, but then East Catholic ran off 12 in a row, and it's been nip and tuck ever since. But, of course, as Jim said, when they got the ball inside to Antonio Shorter in the second half, that has made it for very tough for North Central to control the tempo of the game. But it's been a good game, a hard play game, a lot of mistakes, as was expected. There have been 32 turnovers tonight. And the missed free throws there by Rick Hansen, as well as he's played, really hurt.
That was East Catholic's last time out now on this jump ball. They've got to anticipate, because they probably will not win the tip and try to step in front of each one of the Chargers, Powers does, to see if they can come up with a basketball. There's plenty of time left. They can't take any panic shots like they did the last possession.
So Dave Soles and Robert Whitens have talked with their players now. And, they went through this last night. East Catholic won by 10 over Maple City Glen Lake, but it was a one-point win. And as I say, you have to wonder what the Pilgrims of Lansing Christian think. Maybe they could have been in here and played this one right down to the end, too. 63-60, 54 seconds to go. Jim, as he says, the little height advantage perhaps here to North Central. Tip is, it's lost away, and it's a matter of speed, and it comes down. Mike McCormick puts it up, and I think he was fouled. No, he traveled. Well, that's 18 turnovers, 50 seconds to play. Boy, that was a weird play.
Poor judgment there by McCormick.
off-balance shot. Good hustle on his part.
Boy, there's another guy that goes down. No call. I'm not quite sure how East Catholic's playing this defensively. Inside. Oh, what an unbelievable. There's the play of the day. And he hurt himself, too. The bucket will count.
He's calling a jump ball. I believe he's going to call a jump ball, no basket. And that is going to be a very unpopular call.
Well, that's a shame for North Central. Boy, you can hear the boos ringing in here now. I mean, they are ringing. The crowd is definitely for the underdog here. Boy, that's a tough call. That'll be the controversial call of the night. And now, is it stolen away? Yes, it is. Look at this Hanson kid goes down, and he's fouled with 29 seconds to go. They just won't quit. Mike McCormick gets his third foul, and the crowd is still going very hard on this official. Take a look one more time at the foul underneath, and on the line, Rodney Wells. Now, he is 4 out of 6 on the line tonight. 29 seconds to go. East Catholic leads by 3. Now, they at least can cut it. Now, the basket can tie it. If they can get it back, and the way East Catholic's turned it over, that might happen. 63-61. Wells has 9 points. 5 out of 7. 29 seconds to go.
Good rotation. So now it's timeout right away. They got it.
63-62, and we'll keep it right here. And boy, this crowd is really letting this official have it. 63-62. East Catholic, you can hear them in the background. East Catholic had about 100 tickets sold to this game, and in a crowd of 13,609, the cheers can get drowned out a little bit. You can see the Powers North Central cheering section here. So the Jets are one down with 29 seconds to go.
Still plenty of time left in the basketball game, 29 seconds. They're going to set up full court, man-to-man pressure, trying to deny the ball on the inbounds pass.
Well, that's our very first controversial play of significance, and yet East Catholic, which just had to come down here and hold the ball and take the foul, did not do that. It was stolen away. Turnovers have been a big part of the game. Robert Whitens, you know, his record, Jim, is only 63-60. His teams have struggled over the years, but they certainly have not struggled this year. It all fell in place for them. And Dave Souls, of course, we know all about his situation.
East Catholic has been plagued by turnovers the entire ball game. They had 15 in the first half. They played out of control a lot of this half also, but they still have gotten the ball into Shorter, and Clements has had a lot of big baskets for them also.
Boy, the crowd is still working this official at midcourt very hard. That's not the official they're on.
All right, man-to-man pressure now.
28 seconds to go, 63-62.
Looking for the double team.
Over the timeline.
They got him in a perfect spot. They got him hemmed in. They're going to call a foul. No reason to foul the man right there. They had him hung up. They had him hemmed in Death Valley, and they fouled him.
Gerald Whitens gets his fourth. His teammate Rick Hansen in front of us said, don't foul.
You never want to pick up your dribble at the 10-second line right there. Boxed in along the out of bounds because you've actually got two more defenders on you.
You know, though, Jim, they might have had a jump ball and they might have lost the jump ball. And so, therefore, it might have been just
no reason to put this man at the line.
Well, that's true. He's 2 for 2 from the line tonight. Now they can win the game if they get the rebound. Look at this kid, Hanson, do it. But now they can win it. 17 seconds to go. East Catholic is, a foul is called right away, and it's against Mike McCormick reaching in. That's 4 fouls. Listen to the crowd. They're alive here in Chrysler Arena tonight, and I mean all 13,000 or most of them are obviously for Powers North Central. Boy, Hanson, you know, he's not the tallest kid. He did not have position either. On the line will be Scott Johnson. He's their good free thrower, 9 out of 11.
You know, this is kind of a picayune call, though, really, this far away from the basket in this big a ball game. There was a little contact there, but it was a lot of it incidental.
You said it right the first time. Picayune. But it's been a weird game, too. 13 seconds to go, 63-62. Detroit East Catholic with a lead. Looked like they had this one solid away, but nobody's been able to take control. So here's Scott Johnson. He has 20 points tonight. He is 10 out of 12 from the free throw line. And you'll hear this place erupt if he makes it, because it would tie the game. Yes. We are tied at 63 with 13 seconds remaining to be played. Boy, does Powers North Central want this one so badly. And of course, East Catholic does too. Johnson, yes! A one-point lead with 13 seconds to go. They are going to pressure the ball.
They have no timeouts left.
Down the floor, they throw it away! And it will go back to Powers North Central with 9 seconds remaining to be played. East Catholic turned it over.
Very impatient.
9 seconds to go, North Central by one. They'll have to foul him right away. And Darryl Clements gets his fourth foul. And to the line, that is going to send Rick Hansen, who is not a good free throw shooter, as you know. They want a one-and-one instead of a two-shot foul. Let's see.
They're going to give him two.
They give him two shots, and that's a big, big break for Powers North Central. Now, is this a one-and-one foul, or was it a deliberate foul? That's a deliberate foul.
That is a deliberate foul.
He just grabbed an arm. There was no attempt at the ball. So in that essence, it's a good call. Sixth, but he still has got to make at least one.
He's a 48% free throw shooter for the year.
Rodney Wells. Yes. Wells hits it. 11 points for him. If he hits this one, it is all over. They do not have to do anything but just stand away. Rodney Wells, 65 to 63. If he makes it, it should be over.
Good rotation.
No! They can tie it up. 6 seconds, five. Clements down the floor. Clements stolen away! And that'll be the game. 1 second, it is over! Powers North Central has stunned Detroit East Catholic, the defending Class D state champion, 65 to 63, with a remarkable comeback here in the closing seconds of this game. They scored the last 5 points. And Robert Whitens, whose team had never gone past a quarterfinal, a school that is only 13 years old, a school that has not had any tournament tradition whatsoever, came out of nowhere to win the Class D state championship tonight over Powers North Central. Take a look one last time. Down the Clements was obviously going to shoot.
Watch the anticipation.
And it was picked away. He lost the dribble.
Right there by Hansen, the anticipation.
The Upper Peninsula will take home a trophy some 600 miles from Chrysler Arena. Powers North Central, the Jets, are the 1984 Class D state champions, and what a remarkable game it was. We'll be back for the awards presentation and have interviews in just a moment. This is the Michigan High School Basketball Network.
And now the state champs, Class D 1984, the Powers North Central Jets. Joe Dombrowski. Jeff Willa. Doug Molly. Scott Kleiman. Darren Vinson.
That's okay. I don't mind. Don't mind.
Tim Oja. Chris Poquette. Michael Wells. John Charles. Tim Stein. Gerald Whitens. Rodney Wells. Douglas Willa. Rick Hansen. Scott Johnson. And to receive the trophy as state champs in Class D, Coach Robert Whiten.
So there you have it, the look of champions. Powers North Central with a gritty performance here tonight. The Jets made their mistakes, no question about it, but with their 63-60 deficit against them, they scored the final 5 points in this game, and the key basket was really two baskets. They were free throws. Scott Johnson, who made 12 out of 14 free throws. You see him there in the lower left part of your picture with a towel draped around. He made those two key free throws to give his team the lead for good and the victory tonight. It looked as if they were going to go down, Jim. They were down 63-60. Then East Catholic had two key turnovers late in the game, and that really turned it around.
Well, their 1-2 punch again. Scott Johnson with 22 points and Rick Hansen with 18. They led them the entire season. Hansen, as usual, came up with a very gutty performance on the board with 13 rebounds.
Okay, Robert Whiten is with Fred Heumann, and here is one very happy coach who has just won a state championship. Fred?
Bob Whiten's, no reason for me to talk. You tell me how you feel, will you?
Oh, it's just hard to explain. It's some of those things that you just dream about, and, even just getting downstate to us was just tremendous, and then being able to win last night in that big game, come from behind, and tonight, didn't really hit us until the last 3 minutes that, we could win this game, the kids just went out there and did it when they had to. Just unbelievable.
I heard what you said in one of your huddles, that it was something the effect that, hey, we can go baseline on these guys, we can score when we want to on these people.
I think, the first couple minutes of the game was really, we had to try things out and see what we could do, and they were letting us get the ball inside, and they were backing off a little bit when we went to the boards, and early, Rick took it to the basket well, and we felt we could take them inside, and I think they'd give us some confidence.
I look over your right shoulder. How many people do you suppose are in Powers and Hermansville tonight? I think everybody's here.
There's probably about four or five. That's it.
That had to help your team, didn't it?
Right. Oh, these fans all year long have been great, and then in tournament time, we get 75% of the high school kids out to the tournament games, and the townspeople, they show up like this. It's just great. It's unbelievable, and the kids are just on top of the world right now.
Both in the semifinal and in the final. You're down 13 to Lansing Christian in the semifinal. Rick Hansen takes over and decides it's time to play. He did it last night, and he and Johnson did it tonight.
Those kids have been leaders ever since they were in the eighth grade, Rick just does so many things out there. He gets you that big rebound when you need it, and he gets that big basket, tonight he came up with a couple of steals in there when we had to get the ball back. And of course, Scott, he just keeps taking it to the hole, and he, a couple of those penetration drives when nothing else was going, he just took it inside. And just great. The two senior leadership is something that you just can't get enough of that sort of thing.
You hear the people yelling, UP power, UP power. Was that a big factor for you guys today to represent the Upper Peninsula?
I think it was a big factor. We feel that we've got, a lot of good basketball teams in the UP, and, sometimes we feel that maybe we don't get the recognition we should, but, the kids have a lot of pride in the UP, and I think it showed tonight.
I know you're ecstatic. Are you surprised?
Well, not really, no. I think I was more surprised the first quarter when I saw what we could do against them. And then after that, I really felt that we could win the ball game. I guess a little surprised.
You'll take it, I'll tell you that.
We sure will.
Bob, congratulations. Nice
game. Thank you very much.
Bob Whiten's the head coach of the new Class D state champions, dethroning Detroit East Catholic. So a big victory today for Powers, beating East Catholic, and Bob Whiten's very happy man. Tim?
65-63, Fred, as you said, that was our score. And we're going to bring a player in here. We're going to bring Rick Hansen. So before we break away here, we'll go ahead. The other teams are coming on the floor, but we have Mr. Hansen and Mr. Johnson. They're happy. And again, they are now with Fred Heumann. Fred?
Scott Johnson, number 24, my furthest right. Rick Hansen, 18 points tonight, number 32, closest to me. Fellas, congratulations.
Thank you.
Can you
Thank
believe
you.
It?
No, I can't believe it at all. No, I can't believe this at all. It didn't even hit me yet. We're state champions. We're stunned. We came in here underdogs. There's such a great team, five of the last six champions, and we came in there underdogs, and
they were
won.
They were way overconfident. You know, they roomed with us last night in the same motel, you know, and they were up in our rooms, you know, and they were way overconfident. We could see it last night. We came in here thinking that, you know, we just have a fun game, play hard, and see what happened. And we won. I can't believe it.
Were they razzing you guys a little bit in the hotel or what?
Yeah, a little bit. Yeah, they came up, you know, and, you know, they're talking and they were razzing us, you know. They were way overconfident.
They're giving us their thing, you know. They said, we asked them, you got a game tomorrow? They go, yeah. And then, who you play? And we go, you going to win? They go, yeah. And we go, well, you play us, you know. They go, yeah, that's what I said. We're going to win.
Now, come on, now. This is an upset. Did you guys really expect this?
No, not at all. It is an upset. It's a great upset.
It's an upset. Yeah, you know, we just played one hell of a game tonight.
You know, that's what we showed.
At what point in this game did you see that, hey, we can lick these guys?
First quarter.
When they came out, the defense was lousy. They didn't play defense with their feet. You know, they just stood there, you know. And
We knew we could drive on them. We made a few baskets. We knew we had it if we played ball. And so we just wanted to go out there and have some fun.
You guys got to start getting excited about these victories. You guys.
We will tonight, let me tell you. When it hits us. I mean, for a whole week, we'll be excited.
This hasn't hit you yet, huh?
No, it hasn't hit me yet. Oh, it's just so... I can't believe it.
Can you describe to me what was going through your mind when the final seconds kicked off and you realized that this school had its first state title ever?
I don't know what to say. I mean, we're the best team ever at the UP up there. You know, we play one heck of a conference up there, Skyline Conference. And when I looked up at the scoreboard, and we were ahead by 2 points, and we stole the ball at the end. Reddick's went wild.
I'm so happy for our fans. You know, they came all the way down here. There must have been 3-4 busloads of them. And, you know, we came in this game, you know, they didn't even think we were going to win. And look at, you know, I'm just happy for them, happy for the team and everything.
Happy for the coach. Just Coach White is the first year that he ever went any place, you know. First time that he ever won a district, so I even had a good season record. I'm really happy for him.
Scott, it was the Upper Peninsula against the established Detroit school. Did you think about that a lot and the fact that you wanted to prove something?
Yes, it's UP pride. You know, we came down here, when we come down state, you know, it's always UP power, UP power. And, you know, we win a state titles once in a while, but usually it's always Detroit teams or downstate teams.
Yeah, you look in the papers, everybody's rated number one. You know, we're 15th in the state. We're down to 16, you know, and we look up the paper, Detroit East Catholic number one, you know. And
nobody knows about
us. All year we didn't get any recognition.
I think they know about us now.
Yeah, they know where the UP is right now.
You know, fellas, you do it here on the floor. That's where you prove it. You guys did it. Congratulations.
Thanks a lot.
Two great players for this Class D state champion. Very happy and deservedly so. They're the new